वंदे रूप सनातन रघुजग श्री जीव गोपाल को।
I thought a few minutes I will answer the questions. Otherwise, the questions are building up. Too many questions. So, somebody can read the questions. I can answer them. Take this. Take mine.
Prabhuji, I have a silly question, comes to mind various times.
Yeah.
Narad Muni is a post or is he an eternal devotee? Just like Brahma Indra is
post. No, Narada is not a post. Narada is a devotee. Yeah.
When we listen Narad Muni's life, post, past life, Adasi Putra, next life he became as Narada. Can we become a Narada?
You don't have to become Narada, you can become like Narada. Like Srila Prabhupada is a jet age Narada Muni, we call him, right? Narada is traveling, Prabhupada is also traveling. All over the world. Narada is traveling to heavenly planets and Vaikuntha. Prabhupada is traveling to America, in Russia, all over the world and preaching like this. So, one thing is, in the Vaishnava path, we don't try to become Yashoda or become Nanda Baba or become Narada. We try to follow in their footsteps. Take inspiration from their mood of surrender and preaching. Yes, next one.
In verse 42 of chapter 9, it is mentioned that Bhishma transcended misconceptions of duality. What were these misconceptions?
Yeah, duality means sukha dukkha, shita ushna, man apaman. So these are all dualities. So when we are subjected to dualities in this world, we become bewildered in our life, confused. And we plunge our mind into shoka moha bhaya. In this world, normal jivas do like that. They suffer when dualities come. Like Prabhupada says, Indians think America is a more cool place. You know, it'll be so nice if I go there. There is no suffering there, they think. Americans think India is such a nice warm place. So Prabhupada says, Indians think America is better. Americans think India is better. But whether you come to India or go to America, all places are dukkhalayam ashashvatam, he says. So, that is why pure devotee doesn't live in the world of duality, but he transcends duality. What is the meaning of transcending duality? Tam sthiti kshasva, he says, no? Then what is the next verse to that? Yam hi na vyatayantyete purusham pura purusharishabha samadukkha sukham dhiram. That is transcending duality, samadukkha sukham dhiram. Sa amritatvaya kalpate. That's how he transcended. Yes. Next.
Prabhuji, in your lecture.
Duality also means friend enemy. He is my friend. He is my enemy. And I like this, I don't like it. One transcends all of that. And one goes to your transcendental platform, which is spiritual world. Yes.
In your lecture, you discussed that Krishna feels delight to give credit to others. My question is, until and unless we are not fully Krishna conscious, how can we think for a while to give credit to others? I am a practicing newcomer having all anarthas with me. Until unless I am not free from all sorts of anarthas, how can I give credit to others? It seems impossible.
So giving credit to others, he says, is impossible for him. So what we can do, you share the credit with others instead of giving away all the credit to others. Begin with that. Right now, for example, 5 devotees did service and one of them is taking all the credit, grabbing. Is it correct? No. So you share the credit first. Okay, you say that we all jointly did together. And then when you grow after some time, you will say, all glories to assembled devotees. And then all glories to Shishi, Guru and Gauranga. How much glories for yourself? Nothing. That is a very advanced stage. Before that stage, we can share the credits at least. Okay, you want to say, humne kiya. Instead of saying, maine kiya. Correct, no? Like our GIST team, you see, they are doing so many amazing activities. Manjunath Prabhu Keshavanand Prabhu. So when they all come together and do the 5-6 of them, so what should be their consciousness? We did it. We have put Prabhupada's picture in 50 schools. So I should be replaced by we.
Yes.
That is a, that is something easy to begin.
Yes.
Yes.
That
means he could easily realize the oneness with the super soul in quality, because in this world we are Satchidananda, but we have become covered over, due to which paro api manute anartham, correct, no? Whereas when you transcend duality, you can clearly see that I am Satchidananda Vigraha, Lord is Satchidananda, we are one in quality. That is called transcending duality in relation to super soul. Okay, next.
When we do Danvat to
Ananda, then only we can associate with the Lord, no? Because both are Satchidananda Vigrahas. Then they can associate nicely. If I think I am material body and Lord is spiritual body, how we can associate? Incompatibility. Yes.
When we do a Danvat to another person, is it that the original nature of the soul is invoked, because for once the soul gets surprised and forgets its conditional state when someone does godly, goodly, humble things and hence blessed? Is this a good scientific understanding?
Actually, the scientific understanding is this: when you bow down to somebody, their heart blossoms. Like when Prahlad touched the feet of Lord Narasimha, Narasimha immediately saw, who is that touching my feet? Then he saw the small 5-year-old kid, Prahlad. Immediately Lord Narasimha's heart blossomed. It says, you know, Svapadamulam patitam tamarvakam vilokya devah kripaya pariplutah. That's the verse. Uttapya tachirshni adadat karambujam. He kept his hand on the head of Prahlad. He was pleased with Prahlad. So that is the only picture where you will see a smiling Narasimha Dev. Why? How did angry Narasimha become smiling Narasimha? Because of obeisances. Yes. That means Narasimha's heart blossomed with love for Prahlad. Yes. Yeah.
Hello. So even a so-called bad person or very conditioned soul, he also becomes very mild. So does that mean, so when we are falling down, does that invoke the soul and his original character? Suddenly,
yeah, it evokes the original nature of the soul, correct. Perfect, correct, that is true. Yes. It's like the soul's good qualities come out. Yes. Next.
Yes.
Prabhuji, why milk is banned in Chaturmasya if cow milk is glorified in Bhagavatam?
Clear. Some sound is coming out, but I don't know what is the sound. You tell me clearly? Yes.
Prabhu ji, why milk is banned in Chaturmasya if cow milk is glorified in Bhagavatam? Is it only milk or milk products also banned for this month?
Uh-huh. Actually, I have heard from Ayurvedic doctors that when the rainy season starts, the cow eats grasses, so the grass eaten by the cow in the previous month, when it comes as milk in the subsequent month, it is not good. During this month, they say that the input that goes into the cow's mouth, you know, eating, so that grass is such that the milk that comes out of it is not very good for health during this month. That's what one Ayurvedic doctor was telling. Each of the items prohibited, you all know, what are the four items? 4 months, one item. So those items are not good in those months. They are not anukul for the health of the body. Like that, if you ask Ayurvedic doctors, they can give you reasons. They will explain. Next one.
Prabhuji, after Bhishma Dev left material world, he went to Vaikuntha, or as his previous form as Vasus, since Vidura as to Yamaloka or role of...
He went to Vaikuntha, that is what I said. Then you may ask, what happened to one of the 11 Vasus? Who will do that? That you don't have to worry too much about it. Lord will arrange somebody. Like, you know, when Yamaraj came as Vidura, one Ariyama was officiating the post. Similarly, one Vasu has gone back to Vaikuntha, then he will be substituted by somebody. Yes.
Srila Prabhupada wanted to complete the Srimad Bhagavatam, 11th and 12th cantos, also commentaries of Ramayana, Mahabharata, also Varnashrama to be implemented properly. So how to understand he had no desires at the last moment while leaving the world?
Yeah. Actually, Prabhupada said that his disciples should write books on Ramayana and Mahabharata. Prabhupada says that. And they should present very nice commentary, similar to Krishna conscious commentaries of Prabhupada. And although Prabhupada hadn't completed Bhagavatam, still he clearly said, kuch ichcha nahi, that he said, it's there in the video also. You will see, kuch ichcha nahi, he says, I have no other desire. Yeah. Because there is no end to writing spiritual literature. Okay, you finish Mahabharata Ramayana, is that all? Prabhupada also says, all the Puranas we should write, Prabhupada says that. You know, we should give a Krishna conscious explanation. All the Upanishads we have to write, only one Upanishad Prabhupada wrote, Isha Upanishad. So that way, if you see, there are unlimited literature to be, and all the Goswami literature, Prabhupada says, they have to be translated into English and given access to all the people of the world. Now, Gopi Pranandana Prabhu, Bhanu Swami Maharaj, they all have done. So Prabhupada's disciples are fulfilling his desire, and Prabhupada was sure that's how it should be. So Prabhupada said, Kuchichanahi, he said that. Yes. And regarding this Varnashrama, I heard one thing, I'll just show you. Can see. Prabhupada told his Western disciples, see, I didn't call any of these fellows. On their own they are coming. This is Indian. Prabhupada said, India, everybody is Krishna conscious. Prabhupada said, see, on their own they are coming, they are bowing down, they are doing pradakshina. Because they know who is Krishna Balaram. Huh? They know who is Radha Shyam Sundar. And then Prabhupada said, in the same Vrindavan, you go to this Arya Samaji's temple. Prabhupada said, they have no deity there because they have no faith in the Murti, which is their own concoction. Nobody goes there. You can see, it's empty temple because they have not established deity. But we are establishing deity under the guidance of great acharyas like Ramanujacharya, Shankaracharya, Madhvacharya, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. They all are acharyas who worshipped deities. On their authority, we have established Krishna Balaram, Radha Shyam Sundar, and see the crowd, how they are coming. We follow the authority and people come. So Prabhupada said, just see how so many people come to worship the Lord very naturally, because you are creating a pious environment, pious living entities will congregate there. You create a gutter water, pigs will come and congregate. Pigs, you know, mosquitoes, isn't it? Dirty place like that you will find. So he is saying that the river Ganga, river water, is compared to Krishna Katha, where the lotuses come. You know what are lotuses? The lotuses and lilies are compared to Krishna's name, form, qualities, pastimes, and activities of the Lord. They are compared to the lotuses which spring. Because while speaking Krishna Katha, we may begin Krishna Katha with some little background, but eventually we will come to which point? Krishna's names, Krishna's forms, Krishna's varieties of forms, like Matsya, Kurma, Varaha, Narasimha, and all these things. And then there's Leelas, you will speak. So they are all compared to lotuses. And as soon as those lotuses come, they carry honey. What is their honey? Rasa. That is different rasas. So these lotuses carry rasa. And to enjoy that rasa and the fragrance of the lotus, the Paramahamsa, ducks and the swans, they all come and intertwine in that lotus. And the bumblebees are hovering like this. So the devotees are compared to that. So the devotees relish the Nama Rupa Kunda Leela of the Lord. And the river water is flowing. And the swans feel, let this river water never stop. Let Ganga keep on flowing. Let the lotuses keep on remaining as it is. And let us keep on remaining in the company of, surrounded by lotuses. Sometimes have you seen a lotus pond? You can't see even water also. It will be fully filled with lotus leaves and lotuses. How many of you have seen? You have seen it? Correct. No? So all the swans will have a great delight in such a pond. Because wherever you turn around, lotus leaves and lotuses only. So they live in the midst of that and they will never leave that place. And then he says, Kaviraj Goswami says, Shri Chaitanya Dayanide Tavala. He is saying, although my Lord, your katha is so wonderful like Akash Ganga, but my tongue is dry, he is telling, like a desert. Why? Because I am a materialist and I have no good qualities. So my tongue is like a desert. But may your Krishna Katha in the form of Ganga flow on my tongue, so that my tongue will become fertilized, it will be nourished. And in this way, I will benefit and others will also benefit. Like that is telling. Very beautiful. So here, that's what Prabhupada is saying in this end of this purport. About how everything in contact with Krishna is wonderful. And then, in the next third verse, Tam upashrutya ninadam జగత్ భయ భయావహం ప్రత్యుద్యయు ప్రజా సర్వా భర్తృదర్శన లాలసాః. Translation.
The citizens of Dwarka, having heard that sound which threatens fear personified in the material world, began to run towards him fast, just to have a long desired audience with the Lord, who is the protector of all the devotees.
Yeah. See, Bhartru Darshana Lala Saha, he says, which means Bhartru means master, one protector. A husband is called Bharta, Bhartru. So the protector, Krishna, has come. Darshana lalasaha. Lalasa means to want to go and see, that desire. Like for example, say somebody, some guest has come, arrived at the airport. So now the manager is telling, Prabhu so-and-so Maharaj has come, we want some devotees to go and receive in the airport. And then he calls, he's asking, who all would like to go? He said, two devotees are ready. He says, no, Prabhu, we want six devotees to go at least. He says. But others are saying, I'm busy, I'm this. Then he only fixes four more devotees. And then totally he makes six and he goes. Then they go and pick up. So this is called as aupcharik. You know aupcharik? Aupcharik means?
Official.
So officially fixed devotees. So are they darshan lalasaha? No. Now imagine somebody says, Prabhu, Paramahamsa Das Goswami Maharaj has come in the airport. You know, we were thinking it will be nice if some 5-6 devotees go and receive. Devotees come dashing, Prabhu, I will go. I know this Maharaj, I have heard from him. I want to go and receive him, Prabhu. And there is a big fight. We want 6 devotees and 10 devotees want to go, but the smoke can carry how many? No? 8, it cannot carry one. So 8 devotees go in sumo and other 2 fellows go in a car behind. Another Omni they take, both vehicles are going. And then they say, when Maharaj sits in the sumo, some fellows will push them to go to Omni. So like that, both the vehicles are going. What is this? Darshana Lala Saha. Correct, no? Because the eagerness to go and receive the Swami has come from where? From here. From inside it has come. Correct, no? Yeah. So this is very important. You will see that when this kind of love develops in the heart, you know, then this is only something which transforms into love for Krishna later on. Like for example, somebody, we say, this morning Bhagavatam class will be given by such and such devotee, they announce. Correct, no? So if somebody, we can hear the Bhagavatam in various ways. Either we can hear with lalasaha, great lalasa we can hear, great eagerness. Or we may hear because this fellow has been asked to give class and I'm supposed to sit. Like one devotee asked me, he accompanied me to Mayapur and I attended the lecture of His Holiness, His Grace, Jananivas Prabhu. Wonderful class he gave, Bhagavata. Then I came to room, this fellow was asleep. So then I got him up and said, hey, how can you sleep during Bhagavatam class? So he said, Prabhu, I really always wanted to know the policy of our Pune temple. When we go out of Pune, what is the policy? Are we supposed to attend the Bhagavatam class? He asked. I said, what are you asking? Bhagavatam is our pran. You know, if somebody is asking, should I keep my pran or leave my pran? Sanatana Goswami uses the word Bhagavata prana, he says. It is like life itself. Wherever there is sound vibration glorifying Lord, you have to go running there. And that too, Jananivas Prabhu gave such a wonderful class. He said, Prabhuji, I wasn't aware of the policy. He said, hey, what policy are you talking? Nonsense. You don't have to make a policy to attend the class in Mayapur. Mayapur, ocean of mercy is flowing there. Go and dive, take a deep dive there. So that means this person, lalasa is not there. Correct, no? Lalasa to hear and associate is not there. So, when great souls come, when Swamis, Maharajas come to a temple general, if one wishes to get some doubts clarified, after the class one can meet them, beg them to answer some question, find out if I can render some service to them in some way, then one makes a lot of advancement. And lalasa is there. When Lalasa is not there, like one devotee is asking, Prabhuji, so and so Maharaj is giving Bhagavatam class today. He started at 8:40. And if the class goes beyond 9:30, what are we supposed to do? What is the meaning of the question? You understand? Huh? In case Maharaj gives beyond 9:30 and we have too many services to do, then what are we supposed to do? Huh? He can?
You can sit in here.
Okay. Basically, he is looking for what? Some exemption. He says, okay, Prabhu, 9:30 you can get up and go back and do your services. Maybe if you have a FM, you may hear it with FM. Yes, I have to hear or I can hear, Prabhu. Correct, no? Okay, you may hear if you like. Correct, no? That means Lalasa is not there. So here these people were having Bhartru Darshana Lalasaha, he says. So they had Darshan Lalasa. Like for example, festival day, all people gather in the temple, isn't it? Big crowd of people, and the Lord is going to be decorated with beautiful dress, new dress or new shringar. Everybody wants to watch. So devotees are Darshan Lalasa. As soon as the altar opens, Hari Bol, everybody is falling on the ground, offering obeisances, tearing up. All the thousands of eyes are on one person, Supreme Lord. Isn't it? So that is called Darshana Lalasa, the eager. Like that, the Dwaraka Vasis, when Dwaraka Krishna is entering, everybody's eyes were searching, where is our Lord? Where is our Master? Who is our apple of our eyes? Who is our life and soul? For a long time, we have not seen him because he had gone to help the Pandavas. Now he has come back. Their hearts were beating faster. They immediately got up and came running to greet him, receive him, look upon his beautiful face, and express their affection to him. So they all came running. Bhartru Darshana Lalasaha. And that Lord is the one who removes all the fear, he says. And then if you see in the third para, Prabhupada is saying, the sound which Lord produced, it's identical with the Lord, Prabhupada says. And then Prabhupada is saying below, how one can overcome the fear. Our fear is due to association with Maya, Prabhupada says. But the fear will be gone as soon as one hears the sound of the Lord. And then he says, what is that sound? Mahamantra, Prabhupada's words. So, because Mahamantra is not different from Krishna, correct, no? Krishna blowing shank or devotee chanting Mahamantra, both are same, Prabhupada is saying. By chanting Mahamantra, you become fearless. Just as when Krishna blows a shank, everybody becomes fearless, like that Prabhupada is saying. And another thing happened, when the Lord blew the shank, then all the Dwarkavasis got up, whatever they were doing. Later on you will read Balaram and Pradyumna Aniruddha, some of them are eating prasad, eating. They left their plate and ran. Some of them are lying down in the bed. They got up and ran also. Whatever activity they were doing, they dropped the activity and ran to greet the Lord. All the relatives of the Lord also. So similarly, when the Lord sounds the shank, everybody gets up. Similarly, when the holy name is chanted, the soul in our heart wakes up. Because the holy name is non-different from Krishna. That is why he sings, Jiva Jago, Jiva Jago, Gaurachandra Bole, Jago, Jiva Jago, Gaurachandra Bole, Kota Nidra Jao Maya, Pishachira Kole, Kota Nidra Jao Maya, He's saying, no? He's saying that you are lying in the lap of witch of Maya, but Maya is sharpening her knife to slit your throat. But you are sleeping peacefully. Get up immediately. And how will you get up? Yenashi Aushadi Maya Nashi Varo Lagi Yenashi Aushadi Maya Nasimarana Hari Nama Mahamantra Davo Tumi Magi Krishna Nama Sudha Kuriya Paan Yudavo Bhakti Vinoda Praan Krishna Nama Sudha Yudavo Bhakti Nama Shraya Kori Yatane Tumi Tapana Takana What is it? So there also is saying Krishna Nama Sudha. Krishna Nama is what? Nectar. Koriyapan. Judava Bhakti Vinoda Pranam. And then he's saying, Namashraya Kori, Yatane Tumi. He's saying, taking shelter of the holy name, you endeavor in your devotional service and you will surely attain. So these are all saying the same thing, that the holy name of Krishna is Krishna, and when it is uttered, the soul wakes up. Similarly, the Dwarakavasis, they all got up and they came running to greet their Lord. And verse number 4 to 10, it's very beautiful series of verses on citizens welcoming Krishna and offering him gifts. Tatropanita balayo raver dvipam ivadritaha atma ramam purnakamam nijalabhena nityada prityutfulla mukha prochur Harshagat Gadayagira Pitaram Sarva Sukhridam Avitaram Yivar Bakaha. See, Tatra Upanita Balayaha. Many presentations they brought with them. But their presentations were like a lamp in front of the sun, which means there were different types of citizens. Say somebody was having a textile business, so he must have brought some kerchief or some small towel or something. Somebody has some, pot shops or some lamp shop. They must have bought some pots. Everybody according to their business would offer a gift. Somebody has a jewelry shop. They may offer some small jewelry, some ring or something, gold ring or something he might have offered to Krishna. Every person according to his business would give some gifts and come forward and give some gifts. But in front of Krishna, it is insignificant. Why? It is like taking the Ganges water and offering back to Ganges, isn't it? If you see, we were recently in Haridwar and Rishikesh. That's a vast, the Ganges looks like ocean only there. So much of such a broad width, and Ganges flowing very fast and profuse quantity of water there. And it is flowing. So imagine you get into the Ganges for a bath. Of course, you have to be careful, it will carry you, the current will carry you if you don't hold on. But if you take some water and offer it back as people do, it is a practice in India. When you go to Ganga, you are supposed to take some water and offer it back to Ganges. Correct? We do that. So we are taking from Ganges and giving it back to Ganges. Correct, no? Similarly, the whole universe belongs to Lord. Lord, you take one thing from there and you give it back to Him. From that point of view, if you see, it's very insignificant and small. At the same time, it was given with great love. Like Shabari is giving tasted fruits to Ram, but it is given with great love. So Prabhupada writes in Bhagavad Gita, one should render some service, and that service should be performed with love, he says. That is called bhakti. Service should be performed with love. So when it is performed with love, it touches the heart of anyone. If it is done with that. So here these gifts are all given by different. Like one thing comes to my mind. In our BMS, one child had made a picture of Prabhupada. And then her mother was pushing her, you have to go and give it to Giriraj Swami Maharaj. Maharaj never comes to Pune. Once in many years he comes. But the child went and gave it to Maharaj. Maharaj saw that, very nice. And then Maharaj was keeping it for some time. Maharaj, can I take it back? He was asking. And Maharaj said, oh, I'm supposed to give it back to you. Okay, now I've seen it. Now you can take it back. Mother was saying, why did you ask? It seems Maharaj wants to have. tell Maharaj, keep it with you, Maharaj. Huh? Then the child, okay, Maharaj, you can keep it. The child, okay, Ma, did I do well? Yeah. But then child said, but Ma, but I want it also, because I have drawn Prabhupada so beautifully. So Maharaj understood. Child wants to keep, but mother wants the child to give. And that emotional push, Maharaj understood. See, people like Maharaj, they are very quick to understand. Because they are dealing so closely with Krishna, you know. They can very quickly understand such kind of things. And you know what Maharaj said? You keep this Prabhupada with you now, and later on you draw one more Prabhupada, and that you can give me. And the child was so happy. Thank you, Maharaj, the child said, and took it back and kept it with himself. And the mom said, hey, no, beta, what is this? You committed a big mistake. You tell Maharaj, you keep this, and I will give you one more also. Like that you should do. Then the child was little, having a small face. I said, okay, Maharaj, you can only keep it. And Maharaj said, no, the one which you are going to draw, I will like that more than this. So you draw and give me. That's the last thing he said. So it was like a competition, but the idea is, when we give gift, with what spirit we give, that's very important. You know, when Satrajit was wearing this Shyamantaka jewel on his shoulder, and when he was coming, all the citizens of Dwaraka saw him and they thought he is sun god. And the news reached Krishna's palace that sun god has come. See, our Lord Krishna is so great that demigods are coming to our Dwaraka. And everything, sun god has come. And Krishna smiled and said, that is not sun god. It is a benediction he has got of a Shyamantaka jewel. Krishna clarified. And then people thought, oh, he got a Shyamantaka jewel. And everybody thought the best thing should be given to the king. Huh? So they thought he is going to king. But the fellow came straight and he took a turn and went to his palace. Huh? He didn't give it. He kept with himself. Later on, you will find many things happened. Prasena put it on his neck, his brother was killed by a lion. Then Jambavan took it, and Krishna defeated Jambavan and brought it back. And then Krishna gave it back to Satrajit. So Satrajit felt very ashamed because he had spread rumor about Krishna. So he felt very, very pinched and pained at heart that I committed a big blunder. I should do some kind of parihar. Then he told, I will give my daughter Satyabhama in marriage to you. But along with Satyabhama, he also gave Shyamantaka jewel to Krishna. Krishna accepted Satyabhama. He accepted Shyamantaka jewel, but he saw that Satrajit, he is not giving wholeheartedly. He is giving half-heartedly. Then he told Satrajit, I will keep Satyabhama, but this you can keep yourself. He gave Shyamantaka jewel. And Satrajit, thank you, he said, and accepted. What does that mean? How nicely you understood my mind, eh? And because he kept with himself, Satrajit was killed subsequently. If he gave up his attachment to that and gave it to Lord, his life would have been spared. You will see that. So, in this way, that gift was given by Satrajit half-heartedly. Krishna could immediately understand. So, but these Dwarakavasis, they are all giving gifts to Krishna wholeheartedly. Although it may be apparently, you know, a very small, tiny gift. But it is given with very great affection, which is what is actually more important. Even all of us, we will see in our life also, if somebody gave something with great affection for us, that remains in our head for a very long time. Like one boy had given one small greeting card, you know. Just, you know this, it's how many, 2 rupees at the this thing? 2 rupees card. You've seen small card? Now it is 5 rupees, I think, is it? 5 rupees now, yeah. So the small card, smallest card possible, you can imagine. It's smaller than a postcard also. It has a picture of Krishna. And inside, just 2-3 sentences he had written. But those sentences were very profound because they sprang from his heart. Sometimes we see, when you go to some place, some people give cards, and you can easily know that, you know, this is typical. Dear Prabhu, I am a fallen conditioned soul. You have come in this world to deliver all youths of the world. And you are the most famous youth preacher in the entire world, and things like that they will write. You know? thank you for coming to our center, Hare Krishna, something like that they will write. So you can see this kind, some people write like that. And there are some who will write something very specific, what they heard in the lecture and what they benefited and how something was deeply touching to them. They had some conception before, now they have changed it by hearing. So genuine letters coming from the heart, that will certainly touch the people to whom we write. Because they are not words of flattery. They are not words written out of duty. They are not, they are not words which are simply show off, you see. They actually spring from the heart. Similarly, these gifts are given by the Dwarakavasis from their hearts, very lovingly given. In fact, the such lovingly given gifts certainly touch. That's why you see the next para says, Preeti Utfulla Mukha Prochur. It says that Preeti, Utfulla Mukha, their faces blossomed in Preeti. Out of love, their faces blossomed fully. Harsha means they were smiling. Gadgadayagira means throats were faltering voice. Their voices were faltering. Just like a boy whose father, say, went abroad for 2 months, some project assignment. He's asking mother, Papa, when will he come back? Amar is saying, oh, he'll come tomorrow, beta. And then again, Mom, you said tomorrow, now 2 weeks have passed. When will Papa come? Mother says, beta, next week he will surely come. And the mother is trying to give him different items of play toys to make him forget. And then after almost 2 months is over, the boy really starts screaming, Mom, you have been cheating me, giving different things. Now you tell me when is he coming. And Mom says, definitely he's coming today. But he doesn't trust. But then at last his mother is taking him to airport. And the Papa, he is coming. He's carrying the luggage, he's carrying the wheel bag, everything. And he's coming there. And this boy is running into the airport, although people are not allowed to go inside. Even the airport people are not able to, authorities are not able to control the child. They say, Chodo, no problem. He's running inside. And then going and catching his father. Father lifts him up and is, embracing his neck. And then he's telling his father, Papa, you have gone away so long. So that is the way the Dwarakavasis welcomed Krishna. They felt Krishna is like a father for them. They call him as Bharata. See, they are saying Pitaram. See, the word Pitaram is used. Pitaram, Sarva Sukhridam. Avitaram Iva Arbakaha. Like a son running to his father. That is Avitaram Iva Arbakaha. So, children, as the children run to their own guardians. That kind of, like you see, when mothers sometimes put their children in a school. I have seen this in Dastur school. If you see, the mothers come at about 2 o'clock or something and that gate opens and they go, hundreds and thousands of children are running here, there, in all directions. But the child is looking for one face cut of the mother. Where is my mother? She is seeing different mothers. At last, when the mother's eye and the child's eye meet, the child runs to the mother, correct, no? Because there is a loving connection. Similarly, this Dwarakavasis also, as soon as they saw Lord Krishna, they ran to him like a son running to the father, he says. Natasmate nata sadangri pankajam virincha vairincha surendra vanditam parayanam kshemai hechatham param Na yatra kala prabhavet para prabhu. See, natasma. We all bow down unto you. O Natha, O Master, sada angri pankajam. Your feet are always like a lotus. So to your lotus feet, we all natasmi. We all natasmaha. If I am bowing down alone, I will say natasmi. I will say. Otherwise, natasmaha. Natasvathenata, we all actually, we all bow down to you. And your lotus feet are Virincha Vairincha Surendra Vanditam. Virincha means Brahma. Vairinchya means Kumaras, son of Brahma. Sura means Devatas, and Surendra means leader of Devatas, Indra. Vanditam, because your feet are bowed down to, by who all? Brahma, Shiva, Kumaras, Indra, and all the other Devatas, they are saying. And Parayanam, Kshema Ihechatam Param. Those who desire liberation from this world, they all worship your lotus feet. Because your lotus feet are capable of avoiding everything. If you want bhukti, you can get bhukti. If you want mukti, you can get mukti. If you want siddhis, it can give siddhis. Whatever you desire, your lotus feet are like desire tree. It can offer everything. Even devatas bow down to you. And na yatra kala prabhaved. The time cannot touch yourself. The time cannot have any effect on you because you are yourself kala. You are unaffected by Kala. You are a Shashwata Purusha. Eternally you live. Bhavayanastvam Bhava Vishwa Bhavana. Tvameva Mata Suhrit Pati Pitaha. Tvam Sadgurur Nah Paramam Chadaivatam. Yasyanu Vrityakriti No Bhabhuvima. Translation? Yeah.
O Creator of the Universe, you are our Mother, Well-Wisher, Lord, Father, Spiritual Master and Worshipable Deity. By following in your footsteps, we have become successful in every respect. We pray therefore that you continue to bless us with your mercy.
Yeah. Prabhupada writes in the purport in the middle, the Lord is all-powerful, and if He is satisfied by our obedience unto His lotus feet, He is competent to bestow upon us all kinds of blessings for the successful execution of material and spiritual lives. And then He says, next line, our relation with the Lord is eternal. It can neither be broken nor vanquished. It may be forgotten for the time being, but it can be revived also by the grace of the Lord if you follow His injunctions. As Prabhupada says. So this is a very important verse, very, very beautiful verse. Bhavayanastvam. For the welfare of all of us, Bhavayanaha. Naha means we people. Aham means I, Naha means we. Bhavayanastvam Bhava Vishwabhavanaha. For our sake, you have made this beautiful world where you have given us all facilities. You have given us the sun and moon to provide us drinking water, to provide us grains and fruits and cereals, everything, to live our, to earn our livelihood. You have provided everything for us. And then beginning with that, and then in order for us to come back to you have provided the scriptures, you have provided us temples and saintly persons, everything. So to be happy in this world and to come back to you have provided all that is needed. Bhavayanastvam Bhava Vishwa Bhavanaha. And therefore you are our mother. You are our well-wisher. You are our leader. And you are our father, you are our Sadguru, and you are our supreme deity, worshipable deity. And yasyanuvrtya kritino babuvima. By becoming your follower, our lives have become extremely auspicious, he's telling. See, this is one thing that every Krishna conscious devotee has to realize. How, by becoming a follower of Krishna, my life has become beautiful, wonderful, all auspicious. Colorful. So any of you tell me, how by taking to Krishna consciousness your life has become beautiful, wonderful, colorful, auspicious? Each of us should be able to write a 5-page article on this. Yeah. Then only we can agree that we are grateful for what we have received. Yes? No, we should not imitate Krishna. But we should follow him. Follow means following his teachings. Yes. Like, you know, after we came to ISKCON by reading Prabhupada books and associating with devotees, how have our lives become auspicious, beautiful, wonderful, colorful, and you know, adventurous and thrilling and satisfying? How? Any of you? Few sentences you can speak. Give the mic. There are 2-3 devotees. Quickly give it. Yeah. Give them. Give the mic there. Kirti Gopal. Yeah.
Before coming to Krishna consciousness, we are neither useful to ourselves or any small benefit to anybody else. We were simply rotting and creating disturbance to others, creating disturbance ourselves in the ignorance of ourselves. Whereas when we come to Krishna consciousness, we have a wonderful goal to achieve in our own life, our own glory actually, in servant of the Lord, where we enlighten and enliven others also. With that consciousness, we go and serve them. Mm. The actual service what we can offer to others. Everything else is all superficial. Mm. Nothing goes with them, actually. They don't get benefited.
Very good. Thank you. One more? Behind. Is there one more? Only one mic is there or one more is there? If you raise hand, mic will come to you. Yeah. Give here. Vaibhav, our Bhakti Vaibhav.
Hare Krishna. Actually, the process itself is very wonderful. Like every day we get to chant and dance.
Susukam kartam avyayam, yeah.
And also like every month if you see there is a festival.
Yeah.
Every month like there is like there is Shravanotsav, there is Netrotsav in the terms of Diti Darshan. And like so many things are happening, like so nice association. This is the way it is wonderful. And another like earlier, personally, I never have any like what's the real goal of life, what's the real purpose of life, we never knew these things. Now things are very crystal clear, like what is the goal of life, why what is one supposed to achieve in life, everything is very purposeful. Mm-hmm. And also like there was desire like in my personal case like to do something good to others. So what actually good we can do, I came to know here after coming to ISKCON, like reading Prabhupada books. Mm-hmm. What is the actual benefit we can do to others and to ourselves also.
Very good. Hari Bol. Nicely spoke. Thank you. As one last we'll take. Yes. Mehul Prabhu. Give it to Mehul Prabhu.
Hare Krishna. Actually before coming to Krishna consciousness, there was no goal only in life. Life was going like this only. Somebody is going for IIT, so I was also going for IIT and this, there, everything. So, but after coming to Krishna consciousness, we come to know the real goal of life, what is there. And naturally the tendency is there to love and serve, but we were not knowing to whom to love and whom to serve. Mm. And when being in outside world, when I was doing job also, I saw that to whom I am serving, they are selfish themselves. Mm. And here in ISKCON and in Society of Prabhupada, I am getting this benefit that I am serving the people, those who themselves are selfless. Like even though they don't need my service, but still somewhere or other, I am able to serve Srila Prabhupada and everything. This is very wonderful.
Thank you, Hari Bol. We will take one from Mataji's side. Anybody? Please give the mic to her. Yasya anuvritya kritino babhuvima. You have become fortunate by you becoming your followers. Yes.
After coming to ISKCON, our life has become very regulated.
Mm.
And moreover, we are maintaining the culture, which everybody has forgotten. Before coming to, before joining KC, there was no culture as such. Like getting up late, without brushing, reading newspaper, watching TV till late nights. So when we are doing this, how can we pass on to our children?
Mm.
So hereafter, whatever generations may come, they will be completely spoiled because they didn't see any culture as such.
Mm.
But in ISKCON, the culture has been maintained. So we still have a hope.
Thank you. So in this way, each of us can think about how by becoming a Krishna follower, I have immensely benefited. See, this question is very important. To the degree we are able to think aloud on this question, to that degree our quality of chanting is going to be attractive. If somebody can think like this, many of these devotees spoke now beautifully, you think more and more. You will cry tears of joy. What I have received, the gift that I have received. And some of you thought in certain direction, in the same manner we can think in multiple directions. Who are the kind of gurus and acharyas whom I am following? What are the kinds of books that I am getting to read, the books of clarity, of knowledge? What are the kind of food that I am eating? What is the kind of people with whom I am relating with, like the devotees, and what is the type of relationship I have with the devotees of the Lord, offering obeisances to one another, treating one another with dignity and respect. And what is the kind of job that I am getting to do here? This job is a voluntary service, unpaid service, and it is done out of love. It's loving devotional service. And who is the ultimate master whom I am serving? Who is Lord Krishna? What type of person he is? And Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who is Krishna in the mood of Radharani, we are assisting him. So when one thinks like this, you can think many questions first and then we can think of answers. So the more we think about this, then we will appreciate this. Yasyana vritya kritino vabhuvima. They are saying like this. Aho sanatha bhavata smayadvayam. Traivishtapanamapi duradarshanam. Aho premasmitas nigdanirikshanananam. Pashyema rupam tava sarva saubhagam. Read it, translation. Oh, it's of a good luck that we have come again today under your protection by your presence. For your lordship rarely visits even the denizens of heaven. Now it's possible for us to look into your smiling face, which is full of affectionate glances. We can see your transcendental form, full of all auspiciousness. See, they are saying, Aho Sanatha. They are saying that we have come under the protection of you as our master. So we are all blessed souls, they are saying. And my Lord, your darshan is even extremely rare for big devatas like Brahma, Indra, Chandra also, because they come to the milk ocean, but you are lying deep in the milk ocean on Anantashesh. So, api dura darshanam. They don't get to see you very near. From a long distance they have to see you. And the waves of the milk ocean are rising and moving, and then they are seeing and they are offering you obeisances. And then from there you will give them a message to Brahma, and then Brahma will declare it to all the devatas. This is the relation they have with you. Whereas we Dwarakavasis, we get to see you so near, right in front of us, and you are walking beside us. You are walking, you are glancing at us, you are smiling at us, and you are in such near vicinity that you are watching. Prema, with your love for us, is seen by your smita. Smita means smile. And snigdha nirikshananam. See, snigdha means glistening. Nirikshananam. You supervise us or you look at us with eyes laden with love. Now we all have eyes. We don't know how to put love here. That is snigdha. Snigdha nirikshananam. He said, Lord's eyes move with great love when he is looking at all the citizens. So, we are getting to see you smiling at us and glancing at us very lovingly, like that they are saying. Pashyema rupam, tava sarva saubhagam, the most auspicious form. Like that, even Shiva also says, snigdha pravrit ghanashyamam, sarva saundarya sangraham, charva yata chaturbhahum, sujata ruchirananam. So, he's saying, Snigdha pravrit ghanashyamam. Oh, the Lord's form is bluish complexion, which is like a glistening bluish cloud. It's not ordinary cloud. It's like, you know, it's like a close-up toothpaste. Glistening blue. You have seen that? You have seen transparent, glistening close-up? How many of you have seen? That is Snigdha pravrit ghanashyamam. Sarva saundarya sangraham. So you are sum total of all beauty. He's saying. Charva ayata chaturbahum sujataru chirananam. Your face is like a lotus, he's saying. Padma padrapala shaksham. Your eyes are like lotus petals. Sundara bru sunasikam. Your nose are raised like Jagannath's nose, you see. Raised nose. And your this is like a Chandra, Chandrama, Kapolam, Sukapolam. And then he is saying, Sudvijam Sukapolasyam Samakarma Vibhushanam. Your teeth are placed like a series of jasmine buds. They are very beautiful. And your two earrings which are hanging from your ears are so beautiful. So in this way, Shiva is seeing the beauty of the Supreme Lord. And he is telling this to Prachetas. Like that. Similarly, here also, the Dwarkavasis are appreciating Krishna's Not only they are appreciating Krishna's beautiful face, but also his glance, his smile, his love, which they are able to access in a very intimate manner, getting to see very closely. You see, when Parampuja Gopalakshmi Maharaj had come to Pune once, he didn't come for a long time. 5-6 months he didn't come. Then he came once. There was a big crowd of disciples to meet. So I also happened to be in the room. So I observed one interesting phenomenon that time. You know, when one couple would come, and that they would be standing at the door, and both Prabhuji and Mataji want to make sure that Maharaj has seen them. You know? But Maharaj is talking to many of them, and then they would be folding the palms and waiting. And then suddenly Maharaj would look at them and say, he would look at both of them, and then he would ask them, "Thik ho na?" Like that he will ask. You have seen him asking? "Thik ho na?" Like that he will ask. "Yes, Maharaj, boss." Next moment they will go out. Huh? That much is enough for them, for another 6 months dose they got now. You know? Because they know that he has seen, and not only that, this Maharaj remembers who is who also, and who is working in which company. Correct, no? He remembers and tells. I mean, he is the same one fellow working in Bharat Forge, like that he will say. He is the same one who is a lawyer. He is a doctor who has a hospital in MG Road. Like that he remembers. He remembers the name and the... So, when somebody gets the glance of Maharaj, they are already satisfied. If Maharaj remembers the company in which they are working and Maharaj knows they are doctor or engineer, they are more satisfied. And if Maharaj remembers their name, they will be clean bold. They will faint only there. Are you such a big personality? Why should he remember the name of somebody like me? Such an insignificant person. And besides remembering all these things, Maharaj calls him, "Come here," and talks to him a few minutes. Then, even more, isn't it? That's not like that the Dwarkavasis felt. When Yarhyam Bujaksha Pasasara Bho Bhavan Kurun Madun Vata Suhrad Didrikshaya Tatrabda Koti Pratimakshano Bhavet Ravim Minaksho Rivanasta Vachyuta. Translation. Where is the mic?
O Lotus Eyed Lord, whenever you go away to Mathura, Vrindavan or Hastinapur to meet your friends and relatives, every moment of your absence seems like millions of years. O Infallible One, at that time our eyes become useless, as if bereft of sun.
Yeah, you see, in the dark Amavasya night, when you are going on the road, you know, what is the use of our eyes? You can't see anyone, isn't it? Eyes are there, but eyes alone are not enough. What do we need to see? Light. If there's a power cut on Amavasya day, and you're walking on the road, no bulbs are on, everywhere it is pitch dark. So are our eyes useful? You may stumble across somebody, correct, no? You may hit somebody, bump into somebody, and that fellow is yelling, "Back! Come!" Like they're shouting, and only his teeth are shining. You see, you become afraid. "Sorry, sorry," you say like that, correct, no? So our eyes without the sun are useless. Similarly, Dwarakavasis say that we people without your presence in Dwaraka are useless. We become good for nothing because we cannot enjoy life without you. You are our master. Our eyes have to see you every day and we have to render service to you. And when you are there, then only we feel happiness. Like you see, in a home, if a man, for example, there may be sari of his wife, there may be clips of his wife, there may be umbrella that she uses, there may be her bag which she carries. But if she has left behind all these things and she has gone to her mother's home, in case she has gone for a couple of months. So these things don't give him pleasure, although this may remind him of her, of his wife, correct, no? Similarly, you will find in this world, our happiness doesn't come from things. Our happiness comes from people, you will see. A man comes home, why? He wants to see his wife, he wants to see his child. Yeah? Because in the wife's body, child's body, there is a spirit soul, which gives him that happiness. When that spirit soul is gone, all these items which are lying in the house will not give him happiness. You see? And the spirit soul is attractive because the spirit soul is Krishna's part and parcel. And here the people are seeing that Krishna of whom all the jivas are part and parcel. We all have to see in our own home, we are attracted to sister, our brother, our mother, our father, our uncle, our aunt, our dadaji, different people. And from each of them we derive different type of rasa, correct, no? Now you put all this sum total of this rasa, still it will not match the rasa that Dwarakavasis are feeling for Krishna. Because they are saying, Bhavagyanastvam bhava vishva bhavana tvameva mata, you are our mother. And then Suhrit Patipita, you are our Suhrit, you are our Pati, you are our Pita, you are our Sadguru, Tvam Sadguru na, and you are Paramamcha Devatam. So you are everything. So if Krishna is everything for them, how much love they must have experienced, you can imagine. Correct, no? But how can we imagine it based on the affection and love we feel for our immediate relatives? Based on that, we can understand. All of you think one person in your family whom you love the most. Like say your father or your mother, with whom when you exchange love, how you feel. So they are feeling like this. And because Krishna is the whole and jivas are all part and parcels. So there's a thick relationship between the part and parcels and the whole. There's a natural relation. So Ravim Vinakshor, Vinakshnor, Iva Nastavachyuta, like that they are saying. They are saying, Kurun, Madun, Va Ata Sukhrit Didikshay. They are saying, my dear Lord, sometime you go to foreign place. Foreign means out of Dwaraka. You go to Hastinapuram. Or sometimes you go to Mathura. Sometimes you go to Vrindavan. Some other place. Like that they are saying. See, they are saying here, Kurun, Madun, Va, Atha. So there, this word Va, Atha means Vrindavan also is included. Like that he says here, Vrajabhumi is included, you see. Madun, Va. So Chakravarti Thakur has said, that means Krishna goes to Vrindavan also from Dwaraka. Like that he says there. So you go to different places like this. At that time, our eyes become useless. Because without you, who are we? We have no you have no use of our existence. Like that they say. So, in the 10th verse also similar. Katam vayam nata chiroshite tvayi prasanna drishtya akhilata pashoshanam jive mate sundaraha sashobhitam avashyamana vadanam manoharam iti chodirita vachah prajanam bhaktavatsalah shrinvanonugraham drishtya vidanvan pravishatpuram. Oh master, if you lived abroad all the time, then we cannot look at your attractive face. They're saying, katam vayam nata chiroshite tvayi. Chiroshite means abroad or some other faraway place. Prasanna drishtya akila tapa shoshanam. See, tapa shoshanam means the Lord who dries up the sufferings of other living beings. Akila tapa shoshanam. So because when we look at your prasanna, cheerful face, all our unhappiness is dried up. And jivemate, how will we live without you, Lord? Because your face is sundara, hasa shobitam. Your face is shobitam, is decorated with sundara hasa, with a beautiful smile. Your face is decorated with a beautiful smile. Without seeing that face, how will we live? Jivema, they're asking, how will we live? Apashyamana vadanam manoharam. Without we people having seen your vadanam face, which is manohara, which is heart-stealing. How can we maintain our lives, they are saying. Which means, for pure devotees, the Lord's presence is like life returned. And Lord going away means the life also gone. Like that they feel themselves dead without the presence of the Lord. And this can be understood even in this world. Some people, when they are very attached to their son or daughter, parents, they feel a great pain in their, when they gone away, they, as if their life only has gone. Similarly, sometimes one, like if a wife, some wife has passed away, the husband passes away in 2-3 months. You've seen that? Correct? Because they cannot tolerate the separation. In this world also we have some experience of that. So that prana only goes away. Because one person has died, so the other person who is very closely connected also goes away like that. It has been seen in this world like this. Similarly, they are saying, you are like our prana. You are our very life itself. And then he's saying, upon hearing their speeches, the Lord, who is very kind to the citizens and devotees, entered the city of Dwaraka and acknowledged all their greetings by casting his transcendental glance over them. So, up to this we saw this welcoming Krishna. This is 4-10, welcoming Krishna with our hearts, verse number 4-10. So in these verses, the most important thing is offering gifts to the Lord with our wholehearted consciousness, and offering welcome. This is actually offering welcome to the Lord, and the following 11 to 23 verses give more detail about what type of welcome they gave. Till now there is no starting of welcome. Till now it only talks about how when Krishna entered and Dwarakavasis came running to him and they gave him some gifts. And these gifts were received by Krishna gratefully, although they were small. Different people give gifts. Krishna also reciprocated with each of them when the gifts were given. Because the gift becomes a medium for expressing love, you see. See, when I was in engineering, I used to go home sometimes, once in a year or twice a year I used to go. So I used to think what gifts I should give each of my family members, and I would take. Say, for my mother, I will take some sari. For my sisters, I will take some earring or nose ring or bangles, you know. And there are smaller kids, you take some toy for them, which they will enjoy, or some take some sweets for them. So in this way, my big bag will contain varieties of gifts whenever I went home. You know, twice a year I will go. So when I go home, everybody will come surrounding. And then you open it and you give, mother, this is for you. This is for you. Then everybody, because especially if you give something fitting to them, they will feel naturally very happy. Like you know, you cannot give something that they don't aspire for, correct? No? See, the gift is a small thing. I used to bring some, you know, earring and nose ring for sisters which are roll gold. You know, roll gold? Not very costly. It's in the 20 rupees, you know, 30 rupees. But when it comes from our hand, they feel, oh, my brother brought for me, you know. So that's why I told you, the thing may be small, but when it is, what touches their heart is, this fellow didn't come with empty hand, he remembered us and he has brought something for us, correct, no? Generally we say, actually, mujhe kuch lana tha aapko, lekin time nahi tha, thode busy the hum aage, sometimes we say, you know. So, no matter how busy you are, if you love someone, we somehow get time to pay attention to details. You will see that. So, the gift may be small. It is not a gold ring or a gold bangle or something. Although it may shine for only a few days. When you put water, it will become black. Still, they accept it very happily because it is brought with some affection, you see. So anything given with affection touches even on a material platform. What to speak of a spiritual platform? When we offer anything to Krishna, every morning we all get to offer flower, but it's the same type of flower. That's another problem. One day you get jandu, one day you get long, that what is mogra? Lily flower. One day they give you a rose, one day they give you lotus. Another day, what is that yellow flower which is extremely fragrant fellow? Champa. Another day, imagine they give you champak, round ball-like flower. Imagine every day you get a new type of flower. How many of you will be ecstatic? Correct? Yeah. Very wonderful. One thing is little difficult to get different flower. But even if you are getting same type of flower, as soon as you take the flower in the hand, one should actually think, what prayer can I offer the Lord? You know, what can I offer him? What can I pray from him? Otherwise, it can become like a robotic exercise, you know. Some people, it's like hand exercise, okay, yeah. Like Chandramani Swami was teasing once, he was telling, you know, Chandramani Swami, somebody, Chandramani Swami saw somebody doing like this. He asked, are you offering or are you doing hand exercise? He was asking like that. So, whatever we offer, we have to at least put little bit of respect and affection in it and offer to Krishna. Now we are running short of time. We are in which point now? Second we have finished. In this, I'll tell you which one is. Now, Vedic process of reception reciprocation is about 15 minutes. And cultivating constant attraction to Krishna, that is shorter because we have already talked about Viraha. That is also 15 minutes. And divine nature of Dwaraka Queen's relationship with Krishna, that is 5-10 minutes only. Because there are about 6-8 points Prabhupada gives. So we will do this tomorrow. We were planning to devote some time tomorrow for the first part of the thing. So this, in case this takes about one hour, see these topics. And then the 12th chapter is a very short one, where the Parikshits, it begins with the Parikshit. So what we will do in the morning, 1.5 hours, we start at 8:30, no? 8:30 to 10, at least this will definitely be over, by 8:30 to 10. And then, okay, first two sessions, sir. That is, then it will go till 12. Then Parikshit also will get over. So he is suggesting, Prabhu, can you please check, okay, if you continue first two sessions tomorrow to take both these 11 and 12 topics in detail, as all are getting inspiration and relishing. We don't know whether they are relishing or not. Whoever is writing it is relishing, I think. By these thematic explanations, also we can take presentations in post-lunch session, and then rest of the sessions can be done in the future. I mean, which means the presentations. But one thing Gauranga Darshanpu admitted, he told me, Prabhu, Kunti and Bhishma section are not supposed to be done in one sitting. He said, it's not 3-hour thing. Even in our Vidyapitam also, there also, we didn't finish in one sitting. Gauranga put it in two sittings? 3 + 3 hours, no? 5 hours they took. That sense, I'm not very bad. I'm also almost... It's not that I'm just dragging along, correct, no? Because the chapters are big chapters and very weighty, correct, no? So nobody should tease me for taking this to tomorrow. So, okay, we will do it tomorrow. Then tomorrow we have two sessions, 8:30 to 12, that we will finish it. All right, no? This chapter and next chapter also will finish. But I thought it's required to explain some of this because although the theme is only one theme, the Dwarkavasis are welcoming Krishna, there is a lot to learn from the Dwarkavasis. The following sections are very beautiful in this chapter also. So I will tell one shloka and I'll conclude. You all repeat after me. Naivatmana Praburayam Nijalabha Purno Manam Janada Vidusha Karuno Vrinite Yadyat Jano Bhagavate Vidadhitamanam Tachatmane Pratimukhasya Yathamukha Shri. So this Prahlad Maharaj says in his prayers, he is saying, Naivatmana Praburayam Nijalabha Purno, meaning, my dear friends, understand, he is saying to Lord Narasimha, my dear Lord Narasimha, you know, although we offer gifts to Lord, there is no benefit that Lord gets by our gifts. Because our gifts are very insignificant for him, because he owns, he is Sarvaloka Maheshwaram, he says. And then he is saying, Naivatmana Praburayam Nijalabha Purno, Manam Janada Vidushak Karuno Vrinite. He is saying, Avidushaka, those who are fools in this world, who are ignorant people, who are submerged in Maya, for them to come out of Maya, they are given a chance to offer some gifts to the Lord. And in case those gifts touch the heart of the Lord will desire to deliver them. The Meru and Nabi, those Brahmanas offered up, they said, what will you gain, benefit my Lord, with our gifts? But we are still offering you gifts. You know why? If you keep on offering your gifts, maybe you will look at us, you will glance at us. And when you glance at us, you may feel pity for us. When you feel pity for us, you may desire to uplift us. And when you uplift us, we will become free from all our anarthas. And we will become engaged in your devotion service to your lotus feet. And that way we stand to gain and you gain nothing from us. Like that they say. So therefore, all our gifts are simply to somehow or other turn your glance towards us. And we are trying to catch your attention so that you may consider uplifting us. You will feel some pity for us that a bechara is trying to do something for me. Like that one will feel. So they are in the same manner Prahlad is saying that actually we benefit more than you benefiting from our gifts. Like I told you one example, you remember, if the Prime Minister of India, his shoe is broken and he comes to your bata shop and he wants a shoe, who benefits? Bata, you are a bata shop owner, you benefit or the Prime Minister benefits? Yeah. In fact, no intelligent man will charge any cost for the Prime Minister, correct, no? When he wants a shoe, you will tell him, take any shoe of your choice, sir. Please come, see all the different things. And immediately you will tell your servant, hey, servant, click a photo. While I am showing different shoes, isn't it? And you will make the PM sit in your seat and your whole shop is going to be crowded. Is it not true? See, Prime Minister coming into your shop means you only benefit. In our temple also, NVCC, when we call the President of India, immediately the road was made. Correct, you saw the road now, where we are going nowadays. This road, if you have to make, it will cost lakhs of rupees. You can ask Shri Krishna how much it will cost. You have to put 20, 30, 40 lakhs you have to put. But when President of India came, they said, President cannot come in a road like this, they said. We said, okay, then you arrange a road, nice road. Then they arranged a beautiful road. Similarly, in a bata shop, when PM comes, and then PM says, I like this shoe very much. Okay, sir, please wear it. And the PM may ask, how much, what is the charge? What will you say? No, sir, that's free for you. You will just give it as a gift. You accept it as a gift from us. And while giving the shoe, you will say, correct, no? And then you will put a big board outside your shop. The shop which is visited by Narendra Modi ji. Like that. Narendra Modi is taking a shoe and you are giving a shoe to him. And then people will say, hey, this is a... Even our temple also, many people come. You know why? Are President khud aaya dekhne ke liye kuch to hoga andar. Kaun kya hoga andar? Radha Madhava Chandra andar. You come and see, you know, who is there. Correct, no? So people come because President came and went. Correct, no? So we benefited. That's why Paramahansa Gopakrishna Maharaj brought with great difficulty, President of India, bringing is not an easy thing. So much follow-up has to be done. There are dozens of people involved in between to get him, you see. So in this way, by giving a shoe to the Prime Minister, who benefits? The Dukandar benefits. Similarly, Prahlad says, when we offer you gifts, it is for our benefit we are giving you, not for your benefit. What benefit you will get? So the Dwarakavasis also gave gifts with great love like this. They knew that, what is this gift? It's a very insignificant thing. In our own way we are giving. But Krishna accepted it very gratefully. Because he values every jiva, you see. Can I move this? Because he values everybody, smaller being. Just like Lord Ram valued the squirrel, Krishna also valued. You will see in the later verses, Krishna returned respect to everybody, even the insignificant servants, servant maids, poor people, rich people, all kinds of people. With everybody, Krishna smiled, he wished them, and different type of reciprocation he did with everybody, which we will read tomorrow. Srila Prabhupada ki.